Welcome back to Put You On. My name is Michael. I'm joined by my dad.
Hey everyone, it's Mike.
And today we are going to be listening to Damn by Kendrick Lamar. Dad, this is your third Kendrick album. Pretty familiar with him at this point.
Yeah, I remember the Christmas you had this on your vinyl list, and thought it was interesting, the cover title.
I remember that. Yeah. I remember you commenting on it.
Yeah, I mean, I've never seen anything like it, especially, you know, it's like damn, and specifically with a period next to it, that makes it even more unusual.
Yeah.
And I didn't know that who that was, and I certainly didn't put together, you know, that you had had more experiences with his music since this was his third one.
Yeah, fourth.
Fourth one.
So yeah, this is his fourth studio album, came out in April of 2017. This is the last Kendrick Lamar album, solo album he's put out. As of watching this, Kendrick's album, new album, is coming out within a few hours.
Wow.
Depending on when you watch it or where you're from, the album's already out. So that's exciting, and we're going to be listening to it, and it'll be up on the channel. But right now we have Damn from 2017, easily his most successful commercial album, a couple of massive hit songs on it, and I would probably say it's very close to being my personal favorite album, probably right there with To Pimp a Butterfly. It's probably my most listened to Kendrick album, especially since there hasn't been anything else to listen to in the past 5 years from him, so... Yeah, I'm really excited to get into this. I'm wearing my Damn Tour shirt from 2017 when I saw him.
And fanboy.
Yeah, fanboy. I'm excited. I'm really excited for you to hear this one. Don't know too much backstory to tell you before we get in, just besides that this was obviously the follow-up to Pimp a Butterfly, which was hailed as in extreme high regard. So there was a lot of...
Yeah, hard to believe that, I mean, that I thought that the way the comments were coming, that To Pimp a Butterfly was, you know, the masterpiece and the epic album. So if this is, you know, since this is a follow-up to that one, he has grown on me. He has grown on me as an artist. As much as I, you know, in other videos I said how much I like Kanye West as a person, and I think he's a genuinely good guy.
Yeah,
I am so impressed by the life experience that Kendrick Lamar has had, and the ability and the talent to put that into records.
So we have the intro track here called Blood.
This is almost the same little paragraph snippet that Pharrell did on...
Oh, on A Good Kid.
On Good Kid. Are we gonna
live or die?
So I was taking a walk the other day.
Wow, different voice.
And I seen a woman.
Wow.
A blind woman. Pacing up and down the sidewalk. She seemed to be a bit frustrated, as if she had dropped something and having a hard time finding it. She replied, "Oh yes, you have lost something. You've lost your life." Is it wickedness?
Lamar stated his views on police brutality with that line in the song, quote, "And we hate the popo, want to kill us in the street, faux show."
Ah, please. Ugh, I don't like it.
Intrigued?
Yeah, especially because, I mean, it was a play on the words, right? He says, "Can I be of assistance? It seems you've lost something. I'd like to help you find it." And she said, "Oh, yes, you have lost something."
Instead of "I have lost something."
Yeah.
And then she says, "Your life," and then...
Yeah.
You hear a gunshot. And then that ending bit there, again, this is following up To Pimp a Butterfly.
Is that a real news clip?
Yeah, this is a clip from, I believe, Fox News of them talking about his performance of All Right and them saying how they don't like the lyrics of the song. The white broadcasters saying that they didn't like it. So, Interesting because I feel like I could see you hearing that song for the first time or first getting into him. And I remember you were iffy on the subject matter, but now having sat and listened to him and gained an appreciation, your views have clearly changed on the music and the...
Oh, he's giving me insight into the life of, now I guess what this is going to is the life of a black man. His voice was very different from anything I've heard so far.
Yeah.
Very soft, very, you know, like he was clearly saying, hey, I'm just coming up to help this little old lady looking for something. I'm just doing the right thing. And then, you know, probably just based on off the color of his skin, you know, that's the reaction he got.
I'm going to just go back a little just because I want that to flow into
the way it's supposed to. Yeah, okay.
Into track two, which is called DNA.
This is the kind of boom that makes all of Pa's windows shake.
Inheriting money and power, the maker emeritus. Tell me something, you motherfuckers can't tell me nothing. I'd rather die than to listen to you. My DNA not for imitation. Your DNA an abomination. This how it is when you
ganja.
In the matrix. That
your bullets
what you're sowing. Stacking up the footage, living on the go and sleeping in the filler. Sipping from a Grammy, walking in the building. Diamond in the ceiling, marble on the floors. Beaches out the window, peeking out the window. Baby in the pool, Godfather God. Kenneth's on the way, motherfucker, I got winners on the way. You ain't shit without a buddy on your belt. You ain't shit without a ticket on your plate. You ain't sick enough to pull it on yourself. You ain't rich enough to hit the ladder skate. Tell me when destruction gonna be my fate. Gonna be a fake, gonna be a fake. Peace to the world, let it rotate. Sex, money, murder, our DNA.
Wow.
Comes out swinging out
wow,
the gate.
Wow. Everything he's got.
Oh, man.
Both guns blasting.
That'll never fail to hit. I feel, man, the way I feel when I first listened to it. Something about sitting here with you, knowing it's your first time hearing it, I'm going back to the first time I sat down to listen. And
whoa.
Yeah. Pretty ridiculous production on that too, huh? The sample chops.
Oh, and the amount of words in that whole
the
verse.
Whole second verse, he just rips it apart.
Wow.
Oh yeah. That's, I mean, probably one of the hardest hitting rap songs of the past 5 years.
Godfather Goals. I got my Dogfather shirt on. Wowee.
But yeah, talking about, you know,
yoga. I like this. Yoga on a Monday, stretching to Nirvana, watching all the snakes curving, all the fakes, phone never on. I don't care. That whole thing was wow. that's one where you get the coins bouncing off the hood and you know, who can make it do it, who can make it beat harder. There's no harder beat than that. You can hear it shaking even in the headphones.
Oh, in the car, it's crazy. When Brandon, when this album came out, he used to have that old, remember that old raggedy red truck he had? Do you remember that? Yeah. And that thing was on its last legs. And we would play this album in his truck when it came out every day. And this song would literally, like, it felt like the car was going to fall apart because of how hard it would shake the whole thing. And it was so much fun.
Wow.
This is track three. Track three is called Yeah.
Kung Fu Kenny, this is
new persona you
mentioned.
Yep. Theories and suspicions. I'm diagnosed with real nigga conditions. Today is the day
I can't believe how much his voice changed.
Yeah,
it's not the same.
No, it's like a different rapper.
I double parked the Austin in the red. My mama told me that I'ma work myself to death. My girl told me don't let these hoes get in my head. My world been ecstatic. I checked the signal that red buzzing.
Is it intentional?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Interviews wanna know my thoughts and opinions. Fox News wanna use my name for percentage. My latest news is my niece, she worth living. See me on the TV and scream, that's Uncle Kendrick. Yeah, that's the business. Somebody tell Gerardo this nigga got some ambition. I'm not a politician. Not about a religion. I'm an Israelite. Don't call me black no more. That word is only a color. It ain't facts no more. Everyone together now. Know that we forever buzzing. Radars is buzzing. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Huge change of pace from track one.
And two.
Yeah. That's what, I meant the last track.
So he's still mentioning religion.
Yep.
And it seems just as important to him now in this, you know, he's referencing Deuteronomy.
Yeah.
And he knows God walks the earth, but it's the money.
Right.
You know, it's the money to get, the bitches to hit. Zeros to flip. Temptation is. Yep.
Right. And like you said, speaking on what's.
And I'm an Israelite. That's interesting.
Yeah. And he's speaking on what's important to him now in his life. Religion. He mentions his niece seeing him on the TV.
Yeah, that's great.
Getting excited.
Yeah.
He's also wraps up the thing we're talking about, the Fox News thing.
Yeah.
Fox wants to use my name for percentage.
Right. Right.
But. That's cool how he says Fox News and wants to use my name for percentage. But then he says, but my niece saw it and said, hey, that's Uncle Kendrick. Like, that's what's important to him. He's like, oh, look, my niece is happy that I'm on TV. I don't care what they're saying about me.
Yeah.
That's not important to me right now.
Yeah. His voice doesn't sound like the same youthful Kendrick that I heard on Mad City.
Right.
This sounds like this is a man now who's grown out of that stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm excited to see.
Hooked already.
Now. Yeah.
We have track number four. This track is called Element.
Y'all know what happens on Earth stays on Earth. Here we go.
I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck.
I'm willing to die for this shit. I done cried for this shit. Might take a lie for this shit. Put the Bible down and go out for a knife for this shit. DOT, my enemy, won't catch a vibe for this shit. Aye. I've been stumped out in front of my mama. My daddy commissary made it to commerce. Bitch, all my grandma's dead. So ain't nobody praying for me, I'm on your head, ayy. 30 millions later, no defense watching. Auntie on my telegram like, be cautious. I be hanging out at Tams, I be on Stockton. I don't do it for the gram, I do it for Compton. I'm willing to die for the shit, nigga. I'd take your fucking life for the shit, nigga. We ain't going back to broke, family selling dope. That's why you nanny ass rap niggas better know. If I gotta slap a pussy ass nigga, I'ma make it look sexy. I gotta go hard on the bitch, I'ma make it look sexy. I pull up, hop out, route, made it look sexy. They won't take me out my element. Nah, take me out my element. I'm allergic to a bitch, nigga, ayy. An imaginary rich nigga, ayy. Seven figures, hoe, that's slimmer than my bitch figure, ayy. I got them by a landslide, we talk about races. You know there's never be a tie, just look at they laces. You know careers take off, just gotta be patient. Mr. 1 through 5, that's the only logic. Fake my death, go to Cuba, that's the only option. If I gotta slap a pussy ass nigga, I'ma make it look sexy. If I gotta go hard on a bitch, I'ma make it look sexy. Niggas thought that K-Dot real life is the same life they see on TV, huh? Niggas wanna flex on me and be in LA for free, huh? Next time they hit the 10 freeway, we need receipt, huh?
Cause most of y'all ain't real.
Most of y'all go squeal. Most of y'all just envy, but jealousy get you killed. Most of y'all throw rocks and try to hide your hand. Just say his name and I promise that you'll see Candyman. Because it's all in your eyes. Most of y'all tell lies. Most of y'all don't fade. Most of y'all been advised. Last OP I tried to lift a black artist. But it's a difference between black artists and whack artists.
Gotta slap a pussy ass nigga, I'ma make it look sexy. They won't take me out my element. Nah, take me out my element.
This is one of those ones I feel is like, you know, self-congratulatory, you know, patting on the back. And, you know, he's saying, you know, I'm in my element, obviously.
Yeah.
You can't compete. And here's all the reasons why.
Yeah, that's a... That's the staple flex track for a rapper, you know. Probably something that you haven't heard that much from Kendrick.
What's flex track?
A flex, like flexing. I'm top five.
Okay.
Like, kind of intimidating other rappers.
Yeah, I
like,
feel
that's
it.
Him in being his aggressive, like you said, I'm in my element.
Yeah.
Like him stating his place as being great.
Yeah. So... And in the scheme of rap music, those are not ones that I, you know, I get it. It's, you know, the peacock strutting the stuff and, you know, I got the best and I got the
Those
money.
Are the ones I like.
You do?
Well, it's fun when it's like, when I consider him my favorite rapper, period.
So
it's fun when you hear them confidently say it.
Bragging about themselves.
There's very few rappers that make tracks like that that are believable. Like when Kendrick's saying, I'm the best, you feel it. Like there's obviously any rapper can say that, but it's not always as impactful when I really believe it and it's like he knows how great he is. It's a cool, I don't know if you get what I'm.
No, I know what you mean.
Mr. 1 through 5. Because a lot of
what is all that about?
Well, a lot of people have debates on, like I said, I said in the last video, like people will debate on who's the greatest or who's the top five rappers all time. But he's calling himself Mr. 1 through 5. He's saying I'm all
best
five
of all five. Oh wow,
that's the only logic. Then he says fake my death, go to Cuba. That's the only option because a lot of people, it's a popular theory that Tupac didn't actually die, that he faked his death and went to Cuba. So he's saying, I'm going to do the same thing after I finish making music because I'm the greatest. So the next track is track 5. This track is called Feel.
Ain't nobody praying for me. Nobody praying for me. Ain't nobody praying for me.
Production level is so much
top tier.
Yeah, and compared to what we listened to, this is so obviously invested a lot of money.
I feel like a chip on my shoulders. I feel like I'm losing my focus. I feel like I'm losing my patience. I feel like my thoughts in the basement. I feel like you're miseducated. Feel like I don't wanna be bothered. I feel like you may be the problem. I feel like it ain't no tomorrow. Fuck the world. The world is ending. I'm done pretending. And fuck you if you get offended. I feel like friends been overrated. I feel like the family been faking. I feel like the feelings are changing. Feel like my daughter compromised is jaded. Feel like you wanna scrutinize how I made it. Feel like I ain't feeling you all. Feel like removing myself. No feelings involved. I feel for you. I've been in the field for you. It's real for you, right? Shit, I feel like ain't nobody praying for me. Ain't nobody praying for me. I feel niggas been out of pocket. I feel niggas tapping their pockets. I feel like debating on who the greatest can stop it. I
I am legend. I feel like all of y'all is peasants. I feel like all of y'all is desperate. I feel like all it takes is a second to feel like Mike Jordan. Whenever holding a real mic, I ain't feeling your presence. Feel like I'ma learn you a lesson. I feel heartless often, often feeling the falling. I'm falling apart with darkest hours lost in filling the void of being employed with balling. Streets is talking, filling the blanks with coffins. Fill up the banks with dollars. Fill up the graves with fathers. Fill up the babies with bullshit. Internet blogs and pulpit. Fill them with gossip. I feel like there's gotta be the feeling where Pac was. The feeling of an apocalypse happening, but nothing is awkward. The feeling won't prosper. The feeling is toxic. I feel like I'm boxing demons, monsters, false prophets, scheming sponsors, industry promises, niggas, bitches, honkies, crackers, Compton, church, religion, token, blacks in bondage, lawsuit visits, subpoena served in concert. Fuck your feelings, I mean this for imposters. I can feel it, the phoenix sure to watch us. I can feel it, the dream is more than process.
Who praying for me? Ain't nobody praying.
That one makes me concerned for him, feel, because now he's talking about a lot of the pressures that he's under,
yeah,
constantly. And, you know, we've mentioned this on many an artist, and, you know, there's real temptation there to say, fuck it all. And, but I think by putting it into words, he's getting it out there.
Yeah.
Which is important.
Yeah. That song feels like uncontrollable pouring out of thoughts and emotions that have been built up, right? It's like an unstoppable flow. Like he doesn't,
I can like do this
constantly coming that. Out.
But the whole, you know, I feel like
the so repetition all, of feel.
That's all not facts, right? I once heard that feelings aren't facts. So just because you're feeling that doesn't necessarily mean it's true. So it's really good, but that's almost like a desperate call out. Who's praying for me?
Yeah.
I don't like to hear that. I think he should know that I'm sure, you know, he's prayed for and cared about.
Yeah.
I think that's a real, I think it might be easy to gloss over that in a song.
Yeah.
He's saying it for a reason.
Yeah. That's something that's a theme throughout the album, the praying and pray for me. You can see it on the shirt here.
So it is important to him to know that he's being prayed for.
Yeah. And then we have track number 6 here. This is called Loyalty featuring Rihanna. I don't think Rihanna needs an introduction.
I love Rihanna.
Yeah. More distorted vocals.
Yeah, and maybe backwards.
Yeah.
I said I'm deep and I'm fired up. All I want tonight is just get higher. Girl, you look so good, it's to die for. Ooh, that pussy good, it's to die for. It's a secret society. All we ask is trust. All we got is love. Loyalty, loyalty, loyalty. And I'm always on your mind. I put my lyric and my lifeline on the line. And ain't no limit when I might shine, might grind. You rolling with it at the right time, right now. Only for the dollar sign.
Bad girl, we're in now. Swear, leave it now. On your pulse, I can see the end. Guess on the bitch, like it's premium.
Loyalty. 10-4, no switching sides. Feel something wrong. You wacky, shifty, you don't vibe. Loyalty.
Is it love for the streets when the lights get dark? Is it unconditional when the robbery don't stop? Tell me when your loyalty is coming from the heart.
Tell me who you're loyal to. Do it start with your woman or your man? Do it end with your family and friends? Or your loyalty itself in advance? I said, tell me who you're loyal to.
It's so hard to be another day, baby.
Yeah, you don't have to be. That's an eh for me too.
You know why? I feel like maybe that's advanced for me. Like, I guess if you're a fan, it feels like they tried to make a commercial hit there.
Yeah, I agree.
Okay.
You don't have to. That's a skip for me every time I listen to the album.
Okay.
I it's not horrible. It's like listenable. No, but I just think for a Kendrick Lamar song, I always felt that that didn't fit the, like, it feels very out of place on the album. Like,
okay,
that's just, I mean, I don't know if you probably, I don't know if you feel the same.
Yeah, I'm wondering, it like,
doesn't feel like it fits.
Yeah, like maybe he was catering to her to get her on there or her sound.
And obviously you see large numbers, I'm sure, obviously, because it was Rihanna.
Yeah.
You can't really go wrong with putting Rihanna on a song and if you want it to do well.
Right, but, you know, it's, even her contribution.
Yeah, it's nothing crazy.
No, no.
We have track 7 here. This track is called Pride.
Love's gonna get you killed, but pride's gonna be the death of you and you and me and you and you and you and me and you and you and you and me and you.
Say it feels like a Tame Impala. That feels.
You can say it. Yeah, I agree.
Hell raising, whale chasing, new worldly possessions, flesh making, spirit breaking. Which one would you listen? The better part, the human heart. You love them or dissect them? Happiness or flashiness? How do you serve the question? See, in the perfect world, I would be perfect world. I don't trust people enough beyond their surface world. I don't love people enough to put my faith in man. I put my faith in these lyrics, hoping I make a band. I understand I ain't perfect, I probably won't come around.
I care. Maybe I wasn't there. Maybe I wasn't there.
Yeah, this feels princely.
Maybe I wasn't there.
And that feels Tame.
To the seagulls.
Yeah.
Now in a perfect world, I probably won't be insensitive. Cold as December, but never remember what winter did. I wouldn't blame you for mistakes I made or the bed I laid.
I like the guitar in the back. Yeah.
Just to make a point nowadays.
I love that line.
Smiles,
yeah.
Cold stairs, the temperature goes there. See, in a perfect world, I choose faith over riches. I'll choose work over bitches. I'll make schools out of prison. I'll take all the religions and put them all in one service. Just to tell them we ain't shit, but he's been perfect world.
So he chose not to change his voice at all there. That whole verse was him.
In another life, I surely was there. Maybe I wasn't there. Maybe I wasn't there.
Interesting the use of his voice in the two main verses.
Yeah, it switches from the high pitch to the low pitch.
Verse one, he was
it switches all over the place.
I sensed a little bit of conflict there.
Yeah, I like the line that sometimes I point a finger just to make a point nowadays.
Mm.
I like that. That's very clever writing. Point a finger to make a point.
Yeah, one of the biggest supposed, you know, sins is pride. Pride cometh before the fall.
Right.
So any man that puts himself on a pedestal. But he admits that at the end, right? He says,
yeah,
just tell him we ain't shit. He's is in capital letter, probably meaning his higher power.
Yeah.
He's been perfect world.
Track 8 here is Humble. This was the first single off the album and probably his most popular song ever. This has 1.6 billion streams on Spotify alone. So,
and 11 million views of the lyrics on,
which is crazy. Yeah, this song was
Genius App.
Wildly popular after it came out. This was he put this out right before the album came out, okay, when he was starting his promotion for it. So
nobody pray for me, it been a day for me. Yeah, yeah.
Hey, I remember syrup sandwiches and crime allowances. Vanessa nigga with some counterfeits, but now I'm counting this. Parmesan where my accountant lives, in fact I'm down in this. You say with my boo babe tastes like Kool-Aid for the analyst. Girl, I can buy your Westie world with my base stuff. Ooh, that pussy good, won't you sit it on my taste buds? My left stroke just went viral. Right stroke put a baby in a spiral. Soprano C, we like to keep it on the high note. It's levels to it, you and I know.
He knows his musical stuff, huh? Yeah.
Sit down, be humble. Sit down, be humble. Bitch, sit down, be humble. Sit down, be humble. Get the fuck off my dick, that ain't right. I make a play, fucking up your whole life. I'm so fucking sick and tired of the Photoshop. Show me something natural like Afro on Richard Pryor. Show me something natural like ass with some stretch marks. Still a take you down right on your mama couch in polo sock. Ayy, this shit way too crazy. Ayy, you do not amaze me. Ayy, me humble, sit down.
The piano is taking the place of that other song where it was pumping bass,
808.
The piano does it pretty strong here. That's a great hook.
Yeah. Catchy.
Little out of my wheelhouse in terms of, you know, getting into. I could see that one being huge. And
yeah,
yeah, okay.
You, that was your first time hearing that?
Yeah.
Wow, that, yeah, yeah, that's pretty nuts.
That must be, I'm sure that's a big one in concert.
Yeah, I showed you that video a while back where that was the one where the whole stadium was singing it back to him. It was this song.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it was wildly popular.
Wow.
I mean, you know, catchy hook, catchy beat.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Very, very
digestible.
More modern.
Yeah.
Than, let's say, the older Kanye's you were letting me listen to.
Yeah.
This now is showing me, okay, what year was this one?
2017. Yeah.
I mean, now this is so much more. You guys that listen to this are so much more, you know, bringing me up to this.
Yeah.
Has been a journey.
Yeah.
For me to appreciate this, I don't have enough history in rap.
Or modern, like modern years, like 2010s up. Because we are starting with earlier 2000s, yeah. So. But yeah. This is very modern rap, yeah. This is track 9, Lust. This is yet another one in that raggedy old truck of Brandon's that
was booming,
that we would play and would break his stereo system on. So yeah, this is called Lust.
Oh, that music is really swaying in the headphones, back to left to right. Very hypnotic.
I need some water. Something came over me. Way too hot to simmer down. Might as well overheat. Too close to comfort. That's blood rush, my favorite thing. Heartbeat racing like a junkie's. I just need you to warm me. Am I asking too much? Let me put the head in.
Sounds like Prince. He definitely
super squealy voice, right?
Oh, like just a high pitch. Just even the way he presents it.
Yeah.
She said it's okay. Up in the morning, think about money, kick your feet up. Watch you a comedy, take a shit, then roll some weed up. Go hit you a lick, go fuck on a bitch, don't go to work today. Cop you a fit or maybe some kicks and make it. Not care, I was, or else if I exit, no time for battles. Well, I'm never
Who's that?
Wake up in the morning thinking about money, kick your feet up. Watch you a comedy. Hold up. Wake up in the morning thinking about money, kick your feet up. Hop in the shower, put on your makeup, lace your weave up. Touch on yourself, call up your nigga, tell him he ain't shit. Credit card scam, get you a visa, make it pay your rent. Hop on the ground, flex on the bitches that be hating on you. Pop you a pill, call up your bitches, have them waiting on you. Go to the club, have you some fun, make that ass bounce. It's whatever, just make it
I
count.
I need some water. Something came over me. Let me put the head in.
If it's okay,
she said it's okay.
I wake in the morning, my head spinning from the last night. Both in a trance, feelings are dead, what a fast life. Manager called, the lobby call, it's 11:30. Did this before, promised myself I'd be an hour early. Room full of clothes, bag full of money, call it loose change. Bump on my jewelry, 100K, I lost a new chain. Hop on a bird, hit the next city for another M. Take me a nap and do it again. We all woke up, tryna tune to the daily news. Looking for confirmation, hoping election wasn't true. All of us worried, all of us buried in our feelings deep. None of us married to his proposal, make us feel cheap.
Lately it's all contradiction,
lately I'm not here.
Lately I lust over self,
lust turn into fear.
Lately in James 4:4 it says, friend of the world is enemy of the Lord.
Brace yourself,
lust is all
I
yours.
I need some water.
Let me put the head in.
If it's okay,
she said it's okay.
Very, very.
Have you ever heard a song like that?
No.
I mean, no. As a rap song, it's so unique.
Yeah, I mean, just even mentioning taking a shit. You know, like, he's just taking a shit, and you know, he's so rich. It's definitely depicting the title,
yeah,
to a T. So he definitely accomplished that.
Yeah,
fat beat.
Yeah, and then the ending, him getting into, obviously not the sexual forms of lust, but you know, lusting over fame.
Yeah,
lusting over a routine, which he's talking about two people's routines at the beginning: a guy's routine of him taking a shit, smoking weed, playing some Madden.
Right.
Then a girl's routine of her putting on her makeup, going to the club with her friends.
Oh, I was wondering. But then again, I thought maybe it was just him saying putting on makeup because he had to do 11:30 shoot. So I'm sure they must put makeup on him if he has to go and.
Oh, well, no, he's specifically talking about a girl.
Okay.
Because he's like, call up your girls, call up your man, tell him he ain't shit.
Got it.
He talks about the end there about lusting over routine.
Mm. Is he the prince? The fan of Prince?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, yeah. That's it's evident there.
Well, I think a lot of artists are influenced by Prince as an artist.
Yeah, but still, he incorporates the Prince sound very well there. I could easily see. I mean, if he was alive, that would have been a perfect feature right there.
Yeah, I mean, that'd be amazing. Worked. Yeah. This is track 10. It's called Love, featuring Zachary. Yet again, Zachary, another TDE, his label, another TDE artist.
Damn.
Another big hit
love
song.
Lust. Damn.
All of us.
Give me a run for my money. There is nobody, no one that would run me.
Another world premiere.
So give me a run for my money. Sipping bubbly, feeling lovely. Living lovely.
I wanna be with you, ay. I wanna be with, I wanna be with you, ay. I wanna be with, I wanna be with you.
Just love me.
If I didn't ride blade on curve, would you still
love me?
If I'm in my mind at work, would you still
love me?
Keep it 100, I'd rather you trust me than to
love me.
Keep it a whole 100, don't got you, I got nothing. Ay.
There's nobody, no one that'll run me. So give me a run for my money. Sipping bubbly, feeling lovely. Living lovely. Just love me.
I wanna be with you. I wanna be with you. I'm on the way. We ain't got no time to waste. Popping your gum on the way. And mine away. I don't want pressure, you none. I want your blessing today. Oh, by the way, open the door, by the way. Tell you that I'm on the way, I'm on the way. I know connection is vague. Pick up the phone for me, babe. Damn it, we jamming. That attitude from your nanny. Curving your hip from your mammy. Remember Gardena, I took the studio camera. I know Tap will be mad at me. She's loving. I wanna be with you. I wanna be with you. I wanna be with you, ay. I wanna be with you. I wanna be with you. Just love
me. The way he was rapping sounded different. Sounded like he was, I don't know if he was purposely sounding the way he did, making him sound a little bit vague or a little bit, you know, I can't explain it.
More something more of like a melodic track.
I like the track.
Yeah.
I'm just wondering if his...
Like the stopping and starting, like... da-da-da-da-da-da, and then it stops. And then da-da-da-da-da, stops.
I think it's the way he sounds that is different to me. That's how I almost feel like I don't know what his normal speaking voice is like. I guess I heard it a little bit on some of the stories that he told in Pimp. But this one, I guess if he's, it's almost, he's using his inflections to change the way he's sending the message.
Yeah.
I mean, so Lust definitely had that sound.
Right.
But Love, the just
much
the,
sweeter and softer.
So it's almost like he's, whispering sweet nothings.
Yeah. So the next track 11, is XXX featuring...
You Come too. On, are you kidding me?
So go ahead, take it away.
I mean, I am a U2 fan from the beginning. I followed U2 before they were super popular, an Irish band from Dublin who I've been following probably since 1982.
Wow.
And I've seen them multiple times. Michael, I had the pleasure of bringing Michael
and it was awesome.
My daughter Megan to see them in Madison Square Garden.
Incredible performers.
And that was their modern self when I was seeing them in the 80s. For me, it was like a religious experience because that's how much they meant to me at the time. I'd never heard anything like it. I'd never felt lyrics like it. So I'm so excited to see what would prompt that band to collaborate with
how would you react artist. If you heard Bono start rapping?
he's had
I'm kidding obviously
he, well he no no I he's had rap on some of his albums but you know not even a paragraph or something.
He had Kendrick Lamar on his last album, on their last album. U2 had a Kendrick Lamar feature on their last album. They both did a song for each other.
I'm going to have to check that out.
Yeah.
I did not know that. Oh, maybe that part, something like that, the musical part. Oh, shit. Blessed
are the superstars. For the magnificence in their light, we understand better our own insignificance.
Nice. Shit, I had no idea that was... I mean, how would I know? I just thought it was, you know, somebody they grabbed off the street. But then again, Bono is very political about America and,
Its idea. There you go. Off the bat.
Throw a steak off the ark to a pool full of sharks, he'll take it. Leave him in the wilderness with a sworn nemesis, he'll make it.
Wicked, wicked, wicked.
Johnny don't wanna go to school no more, no more. Johnny said books ain't cool no more. Johnny wanna be a rapper like his big cousin. Johnny caught a body yesterday out hustling. God bless America, you know we all love him.
Yesterday I got a call like from my dog.
Parlay 101. Said they killed his only son because of insufficient funds. He was sobbing, he was mobbing, way belligerent and drunk. Talking out his head, philosophing on what the Lord had done. He said, Kedah, can you pray for me? It been a fucked up day for me. I know that you anointed, show me how to overcome. If somebody killed my son, that means somebody getting killed. Tell me what you do for love, loyalty and passion of all the memories collected, moments you can never touch. I wait in front of niggas, spot and watch him hit his block. I catch a nigga leaving service if that's all I got. Fuck, I mean, yeah. Even keep the peace. Don't you fuck up 1 hour, it be murder in the street. It be bodies in an hour, ghetto burby on the street. Paramedics on the down. Let somebody touch my mama, touch my sister, touch my woman, touch my daddy, touch my niece, touch my nephew, touch my brother. You should chip a nigga, then throw the floor in his lap. Matter of fact, I'm about to speak at this convention, call you back.
Nice. All right,
kids, we're going to talk about gun
control. Wow.
Pray for me.
Damn.
They say the word damn a lot in the album, but
this is what Bono always says. America's not a place, it's an idea.
It's not a place. This country is to be a sound.
I think he used this excerpt on the album too. Yeah.
You close your eyes to look around.
Hail Mary.
Okay.
Jesus,
so that's from there.
The great American flag is wrapped and dragged with explosives. Compulsive disorder, sons and daughters, gang members or terrorists, etc., etc. America's reflections of me. That's what America does.
The mirror again. I never noticed the how frequent that was until you pointed it out.
Mirror and walls.
To be a sound of drum and bass. You close your eyes to look around.
That snippet is basically a sample of a U2 song, right?
Yes.
Do you know what song that is? I don't remember.
Yeah, I think it's the same song.
Is it the same song that he was on? Well, there you go. So they gonna
they
exchange
one off each other. Yeah. Yeah.
But that first half is so
The first half was
badass.
So much. Yeah.
With the siren.
Yeah. What a great. I mean, it got me. It got me going. Like, you know.
Yeah. And the panting and the when he's talking about someone getting shot. I like that line. Ain't no black power. Ain't no black power when your baby killed by a coward.
Oh, it was from there on. It got
intense.
Got even better.
Yeah,
yeah.
And they says unless somebody touched my
mother, my father, my niece,
starts
my,
listing
my nephew,
them all.
My brother, you might as well just chip him up, throw the blower in his lap.
Walk yourself to the, I like yeah. that. Walk myself to the court, bitch. I did that.
Yep.
X-rated. There you go. It's an X-rated description of what he would do if someone.
Oh.
XXX. This track is called Fear.
Why God, why God, do I gotta bleed? Every stone thrown at you resting at my feet. Why God, do I gotta suffer? Earth is no more, won't you burn this motherfucker?
Did they put the translation?
It's backwards.
Yeah.
Earth is no more. Won't you burn this motherfucker? Oh, wow. Sounds like another language. Wow.
And that's why Kendrick is the greatest rapper.
Holy shit.
Ever. Because what's the first line of that verse?
I beat your ass, keep talking back.
I'll beat your ass. Keep talking back. Like, keep talking back. Like, talking back. But the whole verse before it was backwards.
Oh.
And the first line is, I'll beat your ass. Keep talking back.
Oh.
Like,
okay.
Talking back, but talking backwards.
Got it.
I beat your ass. Who bought you that? You stole it. I beat your ass if you say that game is broken. I beat your ass if you jump on my couch. I beat your ass if you walk in this house with tears in your eyes running from poo-poo and Prentice. Go back outside, I beat your ass, little nigga. That homework better be finished. I beat your ass, your teachers better not be bitching about you in class. That piece of bed
Fear.
Not be wasted, you eat it all. That TV better not be loud if you got it on. Them Jordans better not get dirty when I just bought them. Better not hear about you humping on Keisha's daughter. Better not hear you got caught up. 7 years old, think you run this house by yourself.
Nigga, you gon' fear me if you don't fear no one else.
If I can smoke fear away, I roll that motherfucker up.
And then I take two puffs.
Smell like a 7-year-old.
A bitch, pull them panties to the side now.
I don't think I can find a way to make it on this earth.
I probably die anonymous. I probably die with promises. I probably die walking back home from the candy house. I probably die because these colors are standing out. I probably die because I ain't no DeMarcus for snitching. I probably die at these house parties fucking with bitches. I probably die from witnesses leaving me false accused. I probably die from thinking that me and your hood was cool. I probably die cause that's what you do when you're 17. My worries in a hurry, I wish I controlled things.
If I can smoke fear away, I roll that motherfucker up.
I've been hungry all my life.
When I was 27, I grew accustomed to more fear. Accumulated 10 times over throughout the years. My newfound life made all of me magnified. How many accolades do I need to block denial? The shock value of my success promotes in me. All this money is God playing a joke on me. I read a case about Rihanna's accountant and wonder how did the bad girl feel when she looked at them numbers. That type of shit'll make me flip out and just kill some, drill some. Get ill and feel wretched with a lil' some. My practice running from fear, guess I had some good luck. At 27 years old, my biggest fear was being judged. Fear losing creativity, I'm talking fear. Fear missing out on you and me, I'm talking fear. Fear losing loyalty for pride, cause my DNA won't let me involve in the light of God. I'm talking fear. Fear that my humbleness is gone, I'm talking fear. Fear that love ain't living here no more, I'm talking fear. Fear that is wickedness or weakness. Fear, whatever it is, both is distinctive. Fear, what happens on earth stays on earth. And I can't take these feelings with me, so hopefully they disperse. Within 14 tracks, carried out over wax. Searching for resolutions until somebody get back.
Damn.
God damn you. God damn me. God damn us. God damn we. God damn us all.
Verse 2 says, you only have I known of all the families of the earth. Therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquities. I love you, family, and I pray for you. God bless you. Shalom.
That's nothing I can even just comment on right away.
Something I have to digest.
Yeah, that has everything.
So that's broken up into three parts, the three verses, similar to how he did it on Sing About Me, I'm Dying of Thirst.
Yeah.
From the three different perspectives, the third being his. I think Kendrick is an absolute master of storytelling tracks like this and multi-part tracks that connect into each other. I don't think there's anyone better than him.
Oh no. I mean, this makes me feel like
similar to how Sing About Me was, you know, you had the friend's perspective and then you had the female perspective and then you had Kendrick reflecting on it in current time. This also has two opposite perspectives and then him reflecting on the third verse. But the three perspectives in this song are all him. So it's 7-year-old Kendrick, then 17-year-old Kendrick, then current 27-year-old Kendrick. So we got 10 years divided, 7, 17, 27, and what his fears are at each point of his life.
You could tell.
So 7-year-old him. Stuff
being told as a kid.
Yeah.
You know.
So 7-year-old him, his biggest fear was his mother because she was the disciplinary. She was the head of the household.
Oh, sure.
Saying, you know, don't jump on the couch. Don't eat all your food. Don't get your sneakers dirty.
Yeah.
So then 17-year-old Kendrick's biggest fear was death, because as he says in the verse, that's what you do when you're 17.
Right.
Everyone around him is dying at that age.
Right.
Whether from being in the wrong neighborhood, trying to defuse an argument. And then 27-year-old current Kendrick's
losing all that money.
All of his fear, losing his money, being, you know, scammed, taxed by his taxes.
Right, right.
You know, being judged by his peers, losing creativity.
Yeah.
So he chronicles fear through his life in each stage and how it's grown.
Man.
Which.
Not easy.
I just don't know anyone who can do that as well as he does it and entice you for these long, you know, 8 minute tracks and not lose your focus once and right pull you into this long story that he's telling you
and just repeating, you know, fear. I mean, wow, it's this just isn't even songs. This is musical art.
Yeah.
You know, this is, I mean, if that's a story, then it can't be a song. It has to be a creative
masterpiece
item on wax. I mean,
14 track. I like that. Instead of
putting the painting on canvas,
he says that in the last verse. He says, I can't take these feelings with me, so hopefully they disperse within 14 tracks carried out over wax. So he's saying, what happens on earth stays on earth. That's also a common refrain in the album. Like he's saying, feelings, all these song titles are feelings. He's saying, you know, none of this is coming with me, so I'm going to lay them out on wax. Like you said, this is my artwork. I'm laying it out here and I'm leaving it on earth for when I go. It'll live forever.
I don't think I can... Unlike other tracks on here, there's not much more I can add to that other than absorb it, go back and look at the lyrics again, and appreciate what he's doing.
Yeah. So we have the second to last track here. This track is called God.
This what God feel like, yeah. Laughing to the bank like, ah, yeah. Flex on swole like, ah, ever since a young man, all I wanna be was a gunman, shooting up the charge, better run, man. Y'all gotta see that I one man. Slick is out of bars with the finger waves. Work a JT. Handle bars like a fade. Watch me work a JT.
Hold up.
Don't judge me. My mama caught me with a strap. Don't judge me. I was young, fucking other rats. Don't judge me. Aim it at your head for stack. Don't judge me. You feel some type of way, then ah. Fuck is you talking to? Hey, do you know who you talking to? Slide on you like falling drapes. God, touch full of carnivals. I kill him with kindness. Or I kill him with diamonds. Or I put up like 1500. Get your ass killed by the finest. Everything life is a gamble. Nothing in life I can't handle. This what God feel like.
Felt very experimental.
Yeah. I think that might be one that would grow on you after.
He's taking it. I mean, his level of ability to use his lyrics with his music is on display there, where, how do I put it? Like just all that, you know, the aha and
just the whole structure of the song.
Yeah, it's very, very.
Like I was saying, same thing with Lust. That's why I was like, have you ever heard anything like that? Like just as a rap song, it's so, like you can't compare it to any other.
No, he's
rap music.
I mean, what he's doing and where he's sounding is what I guess what puts him there at the top is that. There's no one doing this.
No.
Right?
No.
So he's groundbreaking and breaking the mold.
Yep. This is the final track here. It's called Duckworth.
It was always me versus the world. Until I found it's me versus me.
Remember, what happens on earth stays on earth.
once again, just to remind you, sweetheart, that my
Hail Mary, your marijuana, times is hard. Pray with the hooligan, shadows all in the dark. Fellowship with demons and relatives, I'm a star. Life is one funny motherfucker. A true comedian, you gotta love him. You gotta trust him, I might be bugging. Infomercials and no sleep, introverted by my thoughts. Should you listen, it gets deep. Anthony was the oldest of seven. Well respected, calm and collected. Laughing and joking made life easier. Hard times, mom on crack. A 4-year-old telling his nanny he needed her. His family history, pimping and banking. He was meant to be dangerous. Clacked him a grip and start slanking. Seen his first meal, 20 years old. Had a couple of babies. Had a couple of shooters, caught a murder case. Fingerprints on the gun, they assuming, but witnesses couldn't prove it. That was back when he turned his back and they killed his cousin. He beat the case and went back to hustling. Bird shuffling, Anthony rang. The first in the projects with the two-tone Mustang. That 5.0 thing. They say 5-0 came. Circling parking lots and parking spots and hopping out while harassing the corner blocks. Crooked cops told Anthony he should kick it. He brushed him off and walked back to the Kentucky Fried Chicken. See, at this chicken spot there was a light-skinned nigga that talked a lot with a curly top and a gap in his teeth. He worked the window, his name was Ducky. He came from the streets to Robert Taylor home, Southside Project Chirac, the Terror Dome. Drove to California with a woman on him and $500. They had a son hoping that he see college. Hustling on the side with a 9-to-5 to freak it. Cadillac severely ride his son around on weekends. 3-piece special with his name on his shirt pocket. Cross the street from the projects, Anthony plant to rob it. Stuck up the place before back in 84. That's when affiliation was really 8 years of war. So many relatives telling us, selling us, devilish work, scaling us, crime, intelligent, felonous, prevalent proposition with nines. Ducky was well aware, they robbed the manager and shot a customer last year. He figured he'd get on these niggas' good sides. Free chicken, every time Anthony posted in line. 2 extra biscuits, Anthony liked them and then let them slide. They didn't kill him, in fact it looked like they're the last to survive. Pay attention, that one decision changed both of their lives. One curse at a time, reverse to manifest a good karma and I tell you why. You take 2 strangers and put them in random predicaments. Give them a soul so they can make their own choices and live with it. 20 years later, them same strangers you make them meet again. Inside recording studios where they reaping their benefits. Then you start reminding them about that chicken incident. Whoever thought the greatest rapper would be from coincidence? Because if Anthony killed Ducky, Top Dog could be serving life while I grow up without a father and die in a gunfight.
Now fuck in the ass, need now for that the world.
Now look, I'll never see the ghost.
So I was taking a walk the other day.
I don't know what happened. I can't follow it. I mean, something happened. It's his father. It's his, if this guy didn't kill that guy, I wouldn't have a father. I was trying really hard to hang in there and absorb it.
Yeah, that one comes at you fast.
Wait, what the fuck just happened? I mean,
that song is a brain scramble the first time hearing it.
I mean, wow. Okay, there's a lot of lyrics.
Not to
going
mention
on.
That the beat switches like 6 times.
Yeah.
Throughout the song, throughout a 4-minute song.
Okay, so what I thought Duckworth was the as it's been referenced to, I thought it was his uncle who was, I guess, preaching to him all the Bible stuff.
So Kendrick Lamar's full name is Kendrick Lamar Duckworth. So his real last name is Duckworth.
So Ducky
is a nickname for his dad. His dad
was working the chicken spot.
Was working a chicken spot in Compton that he knew was a notorious spot for robberies and people, and that someone had previously gotten killed there at that chicken spot
in
and 84. Robbed.
Okay.
Anthony Tiffith comes in, and Anthony Tiffith comes to that chicken spot often, and the dad was extra nice.
He likes him.
To him,
right,
in the line.
Chicken.
And because of that, Anthony Tiffith, who originally had a plan to stake out that place
when he did
and shoot it up, he decided not to because of how nice Ducky was. Ducky was Kendrick Lamar's dad. Anthony Tiffith then went on to become the founder of Top Dog Entertainment and signed and brought Kendrick Lamar into his label as a rapper.
So he's saying if his father hadn't worked at the chicken spot, if his father hadn't worked at the chicken spot and Anthony and hadn't been nice to Anthony because he was really was scared of him.
Yep.
And the reputation he had.
There would be no Kendrick.
And offered him the extra biscuits and chicken. Anthony might have shot up the place and killed Ducky. And there'd be no Kendrick.
He played this song for them together at the studio. And both of them being unaware that that had happened. I don't know how Kendrick got that information that this happened. But when he said when he played it for them everyone had an emotional response like, holy shit. Because now here they all like, are.
You're Ducky?
Like, now here they all are sitting there with Kendrick being, you know, the biggest rap artist in the world. And Anthony having son founded this record Ducky. Label.
Wow. Whoever thought the greatest rapper would be from coincidence? Because if Anthony had killed Ducky, Top Dog would be serving life while I grew up without a father and die in a gunfight. Wow. This is, he's made it.
Yep.
And he's now, and he said damn a lot,
yeah.
Right? But not once mentioned, not a song dedicated to it.
No.
But talked about humble, lust, love, fear, God. And then ending it with this story. His last songs on both Pimp and this are like, what the fuck? What did I just, you know?
It's like a mental explosion.
He's got a real...
How crazy is
this
that?
This guy is something.
Yeah. That, to me, easily top five Kendrick Lamar songs. I think a lot of people will say this is their favorite. That's probably my favorite song off the album. And the gunshot we heard at the beginning of the album when he got shot by the old lady, right? We heard that in track one. About that. So that gunshot comes back at the end. The reverse, the reverse passages and stuff, those were a theme throughout. And now this reverse section, if you listen, is the entire album sped up and reversed backwards. So you can hear bits and pieces of the album. And then he says the same.
So I was taking a walk the other day.
The same phrase that he starts the album with at the end.
Wow.
And then also
kudos, man.
There's also he put out a deluxe edition. Not a deluxe. It was like a special edition or something a couple years later. And it was just this same exact album with a different cover, and it was just the track list in reverse. So he was saying that he kind of put that out there as like there's different messages and themes you can get if you listen to the album backwards. So that's just a cool, makes it like a circular album that you can play each way.
What a mind.
I mean, yeah.
A mind.
Yeah. All these little details and...
I mean, this is not just some kid. I mean, this kid was special from the beginning.
Yeah.
And this goes to my point. He had to have the experiences he had to be able to put this music together.
Right.
Number one.
Yeah.
You have to wonder, in any other environment that wasn't violent and fearful and drug-ridden and alcohol and all the things he experienced, if he's this intelligent and genius with music, I don't know. There is leave it at that. I'm just saying he's this was a special kid.
Yeah.
Who went through what he had to get to. But nevertheless, he's a special kid who turned into
an incredible
artist.
Yeah.
Right. And it was meant to be that he had to go through that part of
right.
it to for this to be his art. I physically feel my ribs tight.
Yeah.
Because I don't know what I'm
getting into.
Experiencing.
Yeah.
I've never felt this for this type of music.
We always forget. We didn't do it with the last one too. I always forget.
Well, yeah. So what we decided we would like to do is if Michael has the physical album,
because
you know, sometimes we don't have it and
right.
it gets superimposed. That's not, you know, it's not a secret. Is to, if you don't own the vinyl and you've only listened to streaming, is to appreciate maybe.
I forgot to do it with Good Kid. We could glance at it though while we're here. Might as well. But yeah, so the back, there's a bit of a different
So this
cover.
Is
so
the,
that's the cover. That's the back.
The back of the album.
That's the front.
Which, how did you get the autograph, Mike?
Oh, it was
about that.
It was a, he just, when the album, when he put the album up for pre-order, he did a limited edition. I was just lucky and I got one right off the bat on release day.
Let's open it up.
Yeah. And there, it's pretty simple inside. Let's see. As the album name.
Damn.
And then you have all the tracks with the, just the production credits and the
Additional vocals by
So this is very exciting times.
Oh here. Boy.
We're gonna be experiencing a very special time in rap, and it's really cool that we get to do this together, because there's a lot of talk about this being his last album coming out, that he won't make any more albums after this. It's rumored. He said it was his last album with Top Dog, so he could do more albums under his own label that he's been teasing. But regardless, just being able to experience a Kendrick album in real time is going to be very special. And I'm glad now that you have his previous albums in your brain. So yeah, it's exciting. Again, as people are watching this, it's most likely out depending on what time they watch it. So enjoy it. Take it in as much as you can. And then after a few days of it being out, our video will be up and you get to watch our initial reactions and review of it. So that's going to be a lot of fun.
Thank you, Michael.
That this is going to be exciting. Thank you, everyone, as always, for watching. And we'll see you next week with the new video, Kendrick's new album. Thanks, everyone. Peace out.